Hey guys, today we're going to talk about quickly upgrading grounds on the newer GM trucks. I have my buddy's dad's Silverado in the shop, and today we're just installing a dash cam, and I figure I'd upgrade the grounds in case we wanted to add some auxiliary devices like lighting, maybe a mild sound system, who knows. I just want the foundation to be better. So we've gone over this in other videos for GM trucks, so we're going to go over this for the newer ones. Now, it's very similar to mine on my 2005. You can see here, there is a sensor over here that measures the amount of amperage or how much pull you're putting through the charging system. So we're upgrading the ground here. It's four gauge, fits fine through there. Now you can put a bigger gauge ground through here if you choose to, but you're going to have to distribute the how they did. So you might have to do the junction point at the block or wherever they're getting it from. So here we've taken off some of the paint. We're only taking off the paint in this direction because we're just gonna add our ring terminal over here. So this is a support brace between the cowl and the fender, and we're using that. We could use the 10 mil down there. I'm trying to refrain from putting any new holes into the cab, so I'm just using whatever is existing. So here's everything secured. So running down here, coming up and through. So now I know for the battery side, it's linked up nicely with the cab, and then the factory ground is linked up nicely down by the motor. Now what we've done for the driver's side is we have the side post adapter. So I'm not sure if a lot of you know, on a lot of V8s, even I found on Fords, the thread pitch is actually the same as a GM side post. So I grabbed these copper adapters and I feed it into a hole. That's not a thread that's not being used. And I run it up here. You see our tape matches the factory tape and run it underneath. And then I come back to a factory grounding point. So this is again shared with the motor, but now the cab's sharing it. So we're tying the engine, the battery, and the cab a lot better together. For this application, I'm just using exterior Tesla because it matches what's already in the truck. And then to wrap off the ends, I'm using shrink tube, that way it doesn't want to unravel. Okay, let's see how it starts. Starts about the same. Now, something like this on a truck this new, this is definitely more for preventative maintenance. The wiring is really nice in this truck already, but we're just adding on to it, especially if you want to add auxiliary devices as well to it. So hopefully that helps you out, guys, and for those of you with newer trucks, you understand what this is for and how important it is if you're running any new wire is to pass through it. That way the charging system knows what's going on, because if we were to bypass this, and let's say because this wire is newer, it's thicker, and electricity decides to take the path of least resistance and it starts to bypass that clamp meter, the charging system might not apply the right amount of voltage and do its job properly. So comment below, guys, do you do stuff like this? Do you do preventative maintenance? Do you do foundation work like this when you're adding onto your vehicle? Or do you just hook up auxiliary devices and leave the grounds alone? Comment below, I'd like to know.